Brilliant stuff. Ricky Warwick, when Patsy Cline was crazy and Guy Mitchell sang the blues. How you doing, Ricky?
Good to be here, Johnny. Thanks for having me.
So what was the story behind that? That's a strange title.
It's a strange title, but a great title, I think. A very good friend of mine called Mr. Sam Robinson approached me after the Big Two game got called off on Boxing Day quite a few years ago.
For those who don't know, Big Two, Linfield and the Glens.
Glens.
You're a Glens man.
I'm a Glens man, so is he. And he said he had written a song, and as soon as he told me the title, I knew the lyrics were going to be great. He showed me the lyrics, and it just hit home. It's about when we were wee lads in the 70s, 80s, you know, Friday, Saturday night, if it was a good week or your dad won the horses, a few drinks would come out, the mates would come around, and you'd get to be the DJ, and you'd play Hank Williams, Patsy Cline, Sinatra, Johnny Cash.
Yeah.
So it was written about, you know, that time and that era and a sort of relationship.
Your house sounds like our house.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. We all grew up the same time, the same thing.
You know.
And the lyrics were just wonderful, and I took it away, and within, you know, half a day I'd written the music for it and the melody for it, and that was it. Went from there.
Brilliant. And it's got that sound we've now sort of come to associate with you in recent years. You know?
Lots of guitars.
Yeah.
Lots of guitars. Yeah. It's hard to
beat, you know, it really is.
Love it.
Right. Is the Thin Lizzy thing still going? People are asking me to ask.
It sort of is. I mean, that's really Scott Gorham's thing, and we did 5 shows this summer. We played 5 festivals. It was a lot of fun. And it was a celebration of 40 years of the Jailbreak album and 30 years of poor old Phil's passing. And we had Tom Hamilton from Aerosmith guesting on bass guitar at the shows, which was amazing. And Scott Travis from Judas Priest on drums. It was sort of more of it's built as Thin Lizzy. It was more a celebration of Lizzy stuff. And I think that's where we're at with it. That Scott will just, you know, there'll be every maybe 18 months a few festivals and stuff like that, but no more touring.
But that's terrific. You know, no more touring, but at least for another generation, there's still a chance to see and hear those songs
and that's
the way they should be
heard.
Live, blasting the speakers off the walls.
Absolutely. I mean, the songs are timeless. The songs, you know, live forever. And like you said, we're seeing people that never got the chance to see Lizzy first time round are coming out and hearing those wonderful songs.
Because I'll give you for an instance, my son is 13 now. He did drum lessons in school a couple of years ago.
Yeah.
But thankfully, the songs that they were being taught were things like Highway to Hell and The Boys Are Back Rock and Roll by Zeppelin. So it's all classic stuff, you know.
Yeah.
There's a whole new generation of young teenagers who want to hear this properly.
And like you said, it's classic stuff. It's brilliant songwriting, brilliant musicianship, and you know that's what they should be learning.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Somebody says, Johnny, tell Ricky the Big Two are Cliftonville and Crusaders. Well, for a few years,
I can't really argue with that too much, to be fairness now at the minute, you know.
It's because say nothing yet. Skillful game. But that's right. There's been a bit of a power shift in Irish League, you know. There has indeed. So what do you think of the Glens this season? Glens haven't been up at the top for a while now.
No. I think Gary Harvin's come in. He's doing a good job. The last few games have seen us playing quite well. I mean, it's hard for me to keep up. I'm always sort of phoning my mates, you know, back home on a Saturday night, because obviously I'm living in the States. So, but if I'm following the Twitter feed, you know, at like 8 o'clock in the morning in California time, and it's the Glens. I love them. What can I say?
Yeah, it's one of those things. As I said to my son, he says, "What made you start supporting Man United?" It was a kid for me. It was George Best. But then,
of course,
you can't decide not to support, because it's in you. You just feel it when you watch them.
You
know,
you do.
Even though you fall out when they get beat all the time,
absolutely.
You still, your heart leaps a wee bit.
It's your wee team, isn't it?
But you have no choice in that.
It just
happens. It's a chemical reaction in you. You know. So listen, you're gigging tonight in the Elk.
Yeah, very special gig in the Elk. This is the third year I've done it. We do it for the Glentoran Community Trust, which is a charity set up by the Glentoran Trust there. And all the money raised tonight will go to charity. And part of the proceeds tonight will go to little Zachy Brennan for his treatment, trying to get him to America for his treatment.
Yeah.
Gig's been sold out for a while, which is fantastic.
Brilliant.
Always a good night. Looking forward to it.
Good. And then, of course, in March, you'll be back with the Black Star Riders.
March 5th, yes, we're at the Limelight, promoting the new album, Heavy Fire, which comes out February the 3rd, Limelight's March the 5th, which you reliably
come to Sunday night. Yes, and Gunn are playing as well.
Gunn are special guests with us on that tour, so I've known those guys for far too many years, and again, an amazing band, lovely people, so it's going to be a great night of rock and roll.
That'll be class. But so you've said about the new album, is it recorded already?
It's done and dusted. We did it in Nashville in August, same producer that did The Killer Instinct, the last Black Star Riders album. Guy called Nick Raskolnick. He's done Foo Fighters and Rush and all those kind of things. So I'm very happy with it, and it's all been delivered. And so February 3rd.
Right, Nashville. See, people find that strange. Nashville, sort of, I suppose,
the country thing, and
legendarily
all,
the home of country.
It's becoming more and more.
It's become like a songwriting capital, producing capital, recording. Everybody's going there now.
It's starting to get more towards even rock music. You find a lot of rock musicians have even moved there from California. It's cheaper to live there, I guess. But there's some great studios and obviously fantastic musicians.
Yeah.
You know, our own guitar player Damon Johnson from Blackstar Riders. He lives there and he loves it. Very happy.
Sounds great. So who's in the band then, Black Star Riders, when you come and
we've got the legend that is Scott Gorham is with us, of course.
Whoa.
So Scotty's there, and then we've got Jimmy DeGrasso on drums, Robert Crane on bass guitar, and Damon Johnson on lead guitar.
Some lineup.
And they've all obviously been in various bands, from Megadeth to Alice Cooper to Rat to Y&T. We're all getting old. We've all been about 37 bands now. That's a problem.
Again, and I asked you this before when you got the Lizzie gig. Yeah. Do you sort of stand some nights and pinch yourself?
Every night.
What am I doing here?
Every night. You know, you sort of look over the stage left and there's Scott Gorham, you know, shredding away and still with a swagger and the attitude. And you just go, this is just unbelievable. This is brilliant, you know.
Fair play to you, Ricky, because we all live it through you. Think Ricky's one of our own and he's up there, so that'll do me. This is near as I'm getting.
If he can do it, it's hope for any of us.
But it is, it's class to see. You know, there's yourself and there's Viv Campbell and there's a few people who are up rubbing shoulders with the rock elite, and for thousands of us, it's brilliant to see. You know?
I actually saw Vivian last Saturday. He's out with Last in Line. We end up doing a festival together over in Scotland, and he got up and did Jailbreak with us. He's doing great and looking great. And,
good, glad to hear it, because he wasn't well. Not well.
That's
great. So that's ready. Sold out the Limelight last week.
That's right, yes.
Oh, brilliant. That is. Have you any, do you ever do novelty songs? Are you doing a Christmas song or anything?
I'm maybe thinking about it. When I see the size of the royalty check that Noddy Holder and Jimmy Lee from Slade must get every year, I should think
every
about
year,
it.
Every year. Every year. It's a couple of hundred grand for Christmas.
Well, that's a standard to me. That's the one you have to beat. If you're going to write a Christmas song, it's got to be that or Roy Woods, I Wish You Could Be Christmas Every Day.
Yeah.
They're the two you have to better.
And pay your bills, don't
no
you?
No chance of that.
You know, run about when you're 100 years of just age, you know? No, listen, no problem. Listen, give us a wee song. What are you going to sing?
Let's do Talking to the Glens, Talking to the Show tonight. Do a song called Tank McCulloch Saturdays.
All the streets that made me the man I came to be. The old boys at the Eastern Ghosts of Desert Rats. The boiler suited sports coats, matching season hats. And I won't cry no more. No, I won't cry no more. For everyone I ever needed, everyone I ever believed in, I won't cry no more. Faces in front room flames, where all my heroes came. And Tank McCulloch Saturdays would never be the same. Walking down the Newton Arch Road, singing to myself. Boots inside a shoe shine, and players on the shelf. And I won't cry no more. No, I won't cry no more. Everyone I ever needed, for everyone I ever believed in, I won't cry no more. The Friday tea delivered and sea salt sodden brown. From a village near Jerusalem, on the road that led to town. the ever-listening harmonies with the choir inside my soul. And the sleep that runs into my eyes baptizes through the cold. And I won't cry no more. No, I won't cry no more. Everyone I ever needed, for everyone I ever believed in, I won't cry no more. No, I won't cry no more. I won't cry no more. Everyone I ever needed, everyone I ever believed in, I won't cry no more.
Brilliant, Ricky.
Brilliant. Love that.
Bit croaky after 26 shows.
Listen,
apologize.
Sounds terrific, mate. It does indeed. So just to remind you, The Elk tonight, but it's sold out.
It is. Sold out.
Back with the Black Star Riders, Limelight, Sunday 5th of March. Tickets are on sale now, I would think.
They are indeed, yes.
Yeah. Oh, that'll not be long. Filling up, you know. Hopefully. What I mean. And the new album next year as well.
February 3rd on Nuclear Blast Records, Heavy Fire, Black Star Riders.
Brilliant. Ricky, thanks for
coming
in.
Thank you, mate. Thank you very much.
See you.